I'm going to show you how to set up an automatic macro that will run headers and footers in all your documents. Now, headers and footers are fairly easy to do, but if you have a large document or you have numerous sheets, it's very handy to have one in your macros. So I'm going to show you what I've got it here. So this is open to all workbooks, and so we're going to save it in our personal workbook. And now I'm going to run this. And this sheet has basically nothing on it. So let's go to this view so you can see it says prepared by Barb Henderson and the date. And then it has on the bottom page one of whatever. Book one is what this file is named, and I'm working on sheet one. Now, let's go see how it's going to look on a big one. So I open up a file, and I happen to have a file that's very big. It has numerous sheets on it, and each one of these sheets has masses of data on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my my developer tab, and I'm going to click on the macros, and I'm going to run header. And it goes around a bit. Okay, so now let's just open up a couple of them, and it's gone through each sheet, and so I'm going to go on to my my view so I can see my headers and footers. And if we go through each and every sheet, we can see that it has put headers and footer on every sheet. So you don't have to do it individually. It'll automatically put them on there. So let's look at the code. So here's my code defining WS as a worksheet. And for each worksheet in the workbook, what it's doing is going through. And you can obviously change in any of this to suit what you need. But it's putting putting the name on the top. It's putting the date. And it's putting page one of how many pages there is, then it's putting the file name, and it's putting the worksheet or the sheet name on the end. And the rest of this is just to set up how your margins are going to look. Now, I will include this code in your in the description of the video, but the most important thing is to save this in your personal workbook so that it'll open up in every sheet that you're in. So there's two ways of doing that. You can copy the code into this, or another way of doing it would be when you go to record a macro, you could just record a macro and just start it. And then what you're going to do it is you're going to save it in your personal macro book and just name it whatever, and then close it as soon as you open it. And then you are able to copy, go step into the code after it's there. So I'm going to put another one, and I'm going to call this one example. And I'm going to say OK. And now I'm going to stop this right away. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to go to macros, and I'm going to step into it. And then what I would do is I would copy the code that I'm going to demonstrate, going to provide you in the description. I would copy it right in here, and then you would have your macro gives you headers and footers on every sheet, always available to you in your personal workbook, macro workbook. So this is how you create a macro that will create headers and footers on every sheet that you use. Please subscribe.